I have explained, and today's session is a continuation of the same topics. Just I have added few more. So here I'm going to explain the initial stocks in project. Let's say if you are already having some stock for a project, how you can maintain it, okay, and then how you can issue with reference to your project. And then is a service procurement. We will see the process steps of service procurement, and then we'll see material procurement, and then required settings for all these arrangements. So the first things, as we know, whenever we are assigning any material to a project, that time we are getting item category option. Okay, so we are just selecting, we are selecting material master. Okay, and then same time system is asking to select the item category. Okay, so you can have, you will have two options there. Item category L, which is for a stock item, and item category N, which is for non-stock item. Okay, so the item, the material which you want to take it in the stock, then you need to consider the item category L. Okay, and which is a non-stock direct consumable, you need to consider item category N. So here in a stock item, we are getting options. We are getting an option to create a reservation, and in non-stock item directly, it will go for the purchase requisition. So selecting the procurement type, it is a, when you are going for assignment of material in Project Builder, you will get an option to select the option of a procurement types. Okay, so if it is a stock item, you will have all these options: reservation for network, planned independent requirement, reservation for WBS element, planned independent requirement for WBS element, purchase requisition plus reservation for WBS element. So all these procurement type is coming from the setting of procurement type and configuration. So when we are going for direct procurement is basically the process where we are directly procuring the material for our customer. Okay, so as I have explained in my previous session also, if you want to send direct item to your project, then you can go for this process. You need to correct a project, you need to create a purchase requisition, then it will go for the bid invitation, then vendor selection, then purchase order and monitoring, then good receipt, then invoice verification. So different steps are coming in different modules. Purchase requisition you can create from the Project Builder in CJ20N. Bid invitation, entry of quotation, vendor selection, purchase order monitoring, and good receipt. All these transactions will be managed in material management. Okay. Here, invoice verification, basically it's a integration of MM and FI. So to make it easy, all these steps, I have segregated in a process or the service procurement and material procurement. Here the coming topics, non-valuated project stock. So where you want to, you are not looking to consider the valuation of your stock, then you can consider this option in system: valuated, non-valuated, or no stock. So we are having three options at project definition level. So as per your requirement, you need to select that. So if you are selecting non-valuated, whatever the material you are managing in your transactions, the value will not be available there. Okay, only quantity will be available. Okay, so it's a non-valuated, and here when you are going for the valuated, you can check the valuation of your inventory. So here valuated project stock. For non-valuated project stock, projects or sales order stock, quantity and value flows are separate. Goods issue leads to quantity posting in the network or production order. Material movement are not valuated, which means that is that an FI or CO document is not created. Okay, so what it means when we are receiving any material of non-valuated stock, in that case FI or CO document will not be created. The exception is the good receipt for the purchase order. The WBS element generates an FI document and forced it to consumption. Okay, so this is an exception. Let me go to the exact here, the process step. So here I have taken some business cases. Okay, so my first business case is how you can maintain the initial stock of your project, and then we'll understand the concept of reservation. Okay, and then how we can issue the stock, how we can issue the material item with reference to your project. That is my agenda here to explain Second, we'll go for process procurement, sorry, the service procurement, and third, we'll see the material procurement. Okay, so just understand this concept. Business case one here, I'm focusing on maintaining the initial stock, and then I will issue the material with reference to the project, with reference to the reservation. Okay, so what it exactly here in the SAP, you are having project, this is your WBS element. Okay, so you can maintain your stock at WBS level. Okay, so what we'll do, just consider this stock is having some location. Okay, it will be available in the plant, it will have some material, and then quantity also I'm considering, some initial quantity. And here the movement type is 561 and a special stock is Q. I'll let you know all these details in transaction, but here the transaction code to maintain initial stock is MB1C. This scenario will be available, let's say your project is already going on and you have recently implemented SAP. So whatever stock you are having in inventory, whatever stock, whatever the quantity of that particular material you are having in the stock, that need to be maintained in the system. That is your initial stock. Okay, let's say it was 10 quantity. And then further, after implementation, whatever the procurement will happen, it will come from project order. Okay, so that is another cycle. But initial stock, whatever you are having, that you can maintain it through MB1C. In SAP, to move material from one position or for particular transaction to another transaction, SAP has given movement type to identify it. Okay, so here to maintain initial stock, the movement type is 561. And special stock for project WBS element, it will be Q. So that is a fix. Okay, and here material I have taken as a material master. Material, let's say it's a pump, and initial quantity is 10, and for particular plant, I want to keep this material. So let's say this you have already maintained, and here whenever you need that particular material in your project, that has to be issued to your project. So how it will be done? You can directly create a network within WBS element, which will have the activity, and this activity further, you can assign any material to it. And when you are selecting item category L, system will create one reservation. So with reference to this reservation, in transaction MIGO, you can receive it. The scenario is like that, you have already available stock now. When you are maintained, the stock is available in your inventory. And let's say in project site engineer is looking for some material. So what he will do, he will create one reservation and then he will send it with the vehicle driver, just pick these items from the inventory. So he will go and he will show this reservation, and with reference to this reservation, your storekeeper here will maintain this entry. Okay, and then he will issue the material to the project. So when he's issuing the material, same time the stock is issued with reference to this WBS element, and cost will be incurred on your project. Cost will be posted into your project. So this is the complete scenario here. What are the steps here? First, we need to maintain the initial stock. Okay, so you can see in transaction MB1C, this is a transaction MB1C. Here you need to enter the posting date. This is your document date when you are creating this document. So posting document can be, or posting date can be in past. Here, because in my system, your period is open in September, that's why I've taken posting dates September. Document header text, you can enter why you are posting this initial stock. And this is a movement type, 561. This is a plant for which we are going to maintain initial stock, and storage location where we are going to finally keep our stock. Okay, this is stock, special stock indicator. Q means we are going to keep it is for WBS element. Okay, here individual slip with inspect text, that is only for tax purpose, GRIR slip. So once you are pressing enter, it will take you here on this screen. You need to enter the material master here. What is the quantity which you want to maintain it here? And you enter WBS element for which you are creating this special stock. Okay, so this you are doing in transaction MB1C. Okay, so once it is done, then you will see your stock available in transaction MD04. You can check, that will be the initial stock. So once it is done, the next step, as I said, your project manager or site engineer, he will create one reservation. So how he will create? He will open the project in CJ20 in transaction. Okay, and for a particular WBS element for which already we are having stock, we are having WBS, we are having network activities, and then we will assign material to this activity. So as and when we are assigning, system will create automatically a reservation for this. Okay, so this you will see the reservation number. You can create this reservation in MB21 also. This is a manual transaction, but if you want to create automatically, it has to be in CJ20N. Further, when this slip, the reservation slip, will be taken by vehicle driver, and then he will reach to the storekeeper. Storekeeper will check all the details, and then he will issue the material to the driver. Okay, so he need to create one document in the SAP which we are seeing and goods issue. Okay, so with reference to reservation, we will issue this pump. What is the quantity which we are going to issue? Here you need to enter. So once all data is correct, you just need to click here on the post. Posting entry will be done, and you can check all the data. And then this material will be utilized in particular location. So this is the concept here. Okay, quickly, I'll go in the system to show you all these steps. Okay, then we'll come back for the next scenario. Meanwhile, if you have any question, you can ask.
What is the main use of good evening Sharmaji. What is the main use of non-valuated stock?
Non-valuated, you don't want to consider the value, you are just focusing on the quantity. It's depend on the finance decision how they want to manage it, and it's a core part of material management, how they want to consider what is their strategy.
Okay.
One second, please. Just a second.
An example where we can use the non-valuated stock. Suppose valuated stock, we require the value because it will be posted in the goods issue, so that actual cost will be recorded, right?
It's depend on organization strategy. If they don't want to use go with the value, then it's okay, then they can consider the quantity. There are other factors also, that is a altogether a separate reason for the inventory management. Okay, so I'm using this 21PS user 3 here.
Now one more question, will it create any refinance document or just only the quantity that you will post?
If you are going with the reservation, in that case it will create a finance document. That's why it was written that it is an exception. When you are going for project specific, the good receipt, in that time it will create a
finance.
Okay. So here the first transaction which we are going to consider is MB1C, where we will maintain the initial stock. Okay, so the document date, posting date, I'm considering here September. Okay, and here I'm saying, let's say, initial stock movement type is 561 and plant is 1300 for this, and the storage location is SL01. Special stock, if you see here, we are having some other options also. Here we are going to select queue. Okay, then press enter. Okay, here you need to enter the WBS for which you are going to maintain your initial stock. So let me go to the exact project. So I will make a reference. Let's say this is your project, plant construction. Here I'm going to create one more WBS element for this testing. So initial stock and procurement. Okay, so this is the WBS element for which I am going to maintain stock. Okay, and here coming back to the transaction here, WBS element, and here as of now I'm just entering directly for this material which I have already tested a scenario. Unit of entry, what is the exactly quantity you are maintaining? Let's say if I'm saying 5. Okay, so my material number is this T-22700, quantity is 5. Okay, storage location is SL01, and then I'm going to post it. So once it's posted, one document will be generated here. Okay, that is a NM document number. Now, if you want to see this detail, whether it is available here in this WBS or not, you directly go to transaction MD04. Okay, and you enter the material for which you want to check the store in the. So this is my material and plant I have entered here, press enter. So here you can see the available quantity is 10 because already I have entered some quantity. So as of now, this is my available quantity for this material. Now, let's say this is already, now this is available in my stock, and the project manager or site engineer is looking to have this material on site. So what will be done here? I can create one reservation directly here. So reservation is a document, internal document, which is only saying that yes, we need this particular item on site. Okay, but this is not a guarantee. This is not like just you are blocking the material. No, it's just you are creating a number, and if before you, if someone else is taken that material, then it will, the storekeeper will issue to him. It's not a guarantee that if reservation is created, then this material is reserved for you only. This is just one terminology. So here I'm creating one network. Let's say for procurement. Okay, press enter, and I'm going to assign this material here. So right click here, create internal activity. Here I'm saying initial stock. Testing. Okay, let me save this. Right click here, go to create material component. So this is the same material, item category for stock item. For reservation, we need to go with item category L. So I'm going to select L, stock item. So when I press enter, system will give me one reservation number. This is a reservation number. So here I'm saying quantity 5, which I need on my project. Okay, save it. So once you will save, this reservation number will be generated. If you want to see this reservation number manually, okay, you can check in transaction MD23. So enter the reservation number, press enter. You can see all these details. You can arrange to take one print of all this document. It depends how you want to keep this format. Okay, so yeah. And then what we need to do, then this reservation will be taken to your store, and then a storekeeper will create, he will issue this material to the project. So how he will issue, this is the reservation number. You need to go to transaction MIGO Migo. Okay, and here you need to select the option goods issue with reference to what you are doing. This is with reference to reservation, right? So we have select, we need to select here reservation, enter the reservation number, press enter. Does not contain any selectable item. Okay, I think there was some issue in this material. One second, let me check for another one. I kept one record here. This is pump only. Okay, this is what material, T22700. One second. Just now I've tested the CJ20N. Okay, I got it. What is the issue? So here what we need to do when we are issuing this material, okay, that time this WBS element, this network should be released. So here if you see, this WBS element is in this release, but network is not in the release stage. So this network need to release here, go to status, go to release. So now system will allow to issue this material. Okay, so again, come back to Migo transaction here, and you need to enter the reservation number, press enter. Now all the details is coming here. So pump, this is a reservation number, which is for material pump. The total quantity which we requested here is 5. Material slip number will be entered here. Let's say it's XYZ. And whatever document header number you can enter. Posting date, I need to keep it in the September because that is my open period. So quantity, I'm saying I'm just going to issue two quantity. Okay, then go to where tab here, storage location. You select the storage location from which you are issuing this. So this is your storage location where you are already keeping material SL01. Okay, and then reservation number is coming here. There's a requirement date, there's a requirement quantity, withdrawal, nothing as of now. Account assignment, you can check with reference to which object this reservation is created, network, company code and all. Then select item okay, and then say check. If you are going check, everything is fine, then you can do the posting. So once posting is done, you will see the material document here. Okay, and same time, actual cost will also be posted on this WBS element, which you can see directly in the transaction in report. Go to accounting, go to project system, go to information system, go to financials, and go to cost, go to plan based, go to hierarchical, go to 533 report. So here in classical drill down, you can check for a specific material, but I'll show you for the project level. Now in this project, you can see initial stock, which we have created just now, and this is a network. And in this network, that is my plant. Okay, this is my plant cost. On how we are getting, it's based on the assignment of material to your internal activity. So based on that, my system is calculating it, and this is the amount which I'm posting directly. Okay, so if you want to see that directly, what is the breakup, you just click here, and if you click here, you can see in which network it is posted, what is the activity, what is the GL code. Okay, everything you can see it here. Okay, now next process is for service procurement. If you have any question here, please let me know, any doubt.
In that particular transaction, in the previous screen, that we have seen cost element also. Where we have assigned that cost element?
Direct configuration. Okay, oh. This is, yeah, configuration. So it's not, I'm not assigning here, it's based on some combination of your material management org structure and the material type and all these things.
So one thing just want to add for cost element is, like, you have a material master which contains the valuation class, and in the background valuation class derive the cost element.
Right. Okay. So coming to the next process here, material procurement, let me go first service procurement. Okay, in service procurement, what we are doing, whatever the services we are looking, we can directly create a purchase requisition with reference to your network and activity, or you can create it manually also. So if you are planning to go with the automatic provision, you go to CJ20N and select service activity, you can create a service purchase requisition, and from purchase requisition you can create a purchase order. So this is the sequence here, and once this purchase order is available, it's released, then you can confirm the service entity sheet. So we were trying that same transaction in our previous session, but we were facing some issues. Okay, so that is rectified. I have taken another company code and it's working fine. You can create purchase requisition manually or automatic. So that is a very important thing here. If you are going to create automatic from CJ20N, that PR you can change in CJ20N only. you cannot change in ME22N. But if you are creating that service PR in transaction ME51N, you can change it in ME52N. So here you can release the PR in ME54N. Okay, so we will go transaction wise transaction. We'll create first service purchase requisition from CJ20N. Okay, and then we'll create a purchase order, then we'll confirm the service entity sheet. So let me come back here. This is my project. Okay, and here I will create one more WB, one more network here. Let's say it's my, or in the same, I will create one service activity. Go to procurement, right click here. Let's say I need some consulting. So activity service, consultancy for project. Okay, and here, whatever the options we are selecting, system will create PR accordingly. So if I'm selecting never, system will not create a PR. If I'm selecting from release, system will create PR on release of this activity. If I'm selecting immediately, then PR will be created immediately once this activity will be saved. So here I'm selecting immediately, and now once your service are exist, this checkbox automatically will be selected. And once your purchase order is available, in that case the checkbox will be selected automatically. So I'm entering, press enter. System is asking for purchasing group. One second. Okay, so here I need to enter the purchasing group. Now we can list down all the services here. So let's say if I'm saying service one, quantities, let's say 5, activity unit, gross price is some amount 600,000. Service two, okay, quantities 4, activity unit, some amount 1,000,000. Okay, so come back here, and once I'll see, PR will be generated here. You can see here, PR is created. That purchase requisition directly you can check here by selecting this activity, go to edit, go to activity, and then go to purchase requisition. So this is your actual PR document here. Here you can see the document type. NB document type is standard. Okay, whenever you are creating any PR from project, the document type will be NB. You can change it, this provision in the configuration also. Okay, so here you can see the detail. This PR is created for account assignment category N. You will see, so that is also very important here. If you are creating any PR for service with reference to your service activity, the account assignment category is N. So it means this PR is created for network. When you are going for manual creation, you will get two options here, P and Q. Q means if you want to consider that material in your stock item, you need to select Q. If you want to go for a direct consumption, then you need to select a P. So we'll see this option once you go for the material procurement process. Okay, here item category is for D is for services. Okay, then other relevant data we have entered, and this data is coming from your service activity in the project system itself. Okay, account assignment, service, you can see all the details. So if releasing strategy is activated, the one more tab you will get, and you can release this purchase requisition. So next I'll create one PO with reference to this PR. So to create a PO, I need to go into transaction ME21N. So here is standard document NB, and vendor I'm selecting. Okay, and a purchase organization is 1000, purchasing group is 001, and company code is 1000. Okay, then come back here. Here purchase requisition number you just enter and press enter. System will copy all the details from your PR. Okay, what you need to do, go to delivery invoice. Okay, payment term you can enter, you can select from this option. Okay, conditions, you can check all the conditions here, and text, address, all these details are relevant to your purchase order. Okay, item details will show you the item of the services here. Okay, to see this, go to service. Okay, two services you can see. So here I'm going to save it directly. Once it is saved, you will see one PO number. So this is your PO number. If releasing strategy is activated, you need to release it. If not, then this document will be given to the vendor. It is a legal document signed by both the party. Okay, then that vendor or contractor or consultant will start to work on your project, and then whatever work is done, then it need to be confirmed by the project manager, site engineer, or any authorized person from your project. So this activity need to be done in the service entity sheet confirmation. So the transaction is ML81. Okay, ML81. Here you enter other purchase order. Select enter purchase order number. No, this is not. Let me see what was the purchase order number. Just a second, please. ME23N. I can see, I can display my purchase order number. So this is a purchase order number. Okay, then I'll go separately in transaction ML81N. Other purchase order. Enter here, press enter, then go to create short text confirmation of work. Then here everything is fine. Go to service selection. Okay, then select this one. Here you will get a list of the services. You select that service line item. I'm going little fast because we have already completed these transactions in previous session. So go to service. And here you need to select the quantity which you are going to confirm. So here I'm saying I'm going to confirm two quantity only. Then you can check for any error. Okay, and you can save it. So once you are going to save, system will check for save. So this is the PR. This is service entity sheet number 10000786. Okay, so it is created now, and then and this will go to the next level for confirmation. So here, let's say site engineer is confirming this particular work, then it will go to the project manager for next level of confirmation. So project manager will open the same service entity sheet here in the ML81N, and he will release it. I'm directly doing this steps here. Let's say if you are in ML81N, and you just come here and change and release it. So once you release, this will be accepted on save. Posting only possible in period 9. So what you need to do, you change here period 09/09/2021. So it's accepted. So if it is coming green, so it means it's accepted. Okay. So the same detail you can see here in your report. Go to project system, go to information system, and go to financials, and come here in the cost, and go to plan based hierarchical 533 report. You can check here other data. One second. Check it here. Initial stock, we can check here. So this is the material, this is a service consultancy for project. This is a total plan value actual which we have done here. Okay, you can see it. And next is here a material procurement. So in material procurement, we can create a material purchase requisition directly from the CJ20N or manually also we can create. So I'll go here with the manual option in the case of material. Okay, so then we'll see how a system is considering the commitment, and then how it is going for the actual cost posting. So any question from service? Okay, so next I'm going to create one purchase requisition for material. I will create with reference to WBS element manually. So here, let's say this is my WBS element. 06. Here I'm seeing material procurement. Okay, especially I'm creating this. So here the transaction is to create material PR is ME51N. I need to select here the purchase document here. Account assignment category. Here, if you want to consume that material directly, you select P, and if you want to keep it in stock, keep it in the queue. So let me explain from here first. So here, this is the purchase requisition creation in transaction ME51N. So here, if you want to go with stock, select queue. If you don't want to keep it in stock, then select P, and then enter the material number. Then after that, you need to create purchase order, and then you need to receive that that material with the in your transaction nego. So I'll go in the step. I'll go with the same business case because it's a tested material and all these things. So here I'm selecting Q and material is E-1311. Press enter. Okay, system is asking for plant. So 1300 is my plant. Enter quantity. I need, let's say, 10 quantity. And the system is asking for WBS element. Because I have selected Q, that's why system is asking for WBS element. If I'm selecting N here, system will ask for network. Okay, I'll show you here. System will ask for network. So my my selection of object, account assignment object is based on account assignment category. Okay, I'm changing it to Q. So here WBS element for me is this one. Okay, and here I'm entering this one. So you can check it here. Everything is fine. Delivery date, here it is taken in default based on. So I'm just keeping here the mother date. Check it and then save. So this is a PR number for me. Okay, and this PR number I will use to create a purchase order. So how we can create a purchase order? As we know, go to transaction ME21N. Okay, select the vendor. I'll select the same vendor because this should be. So okay, let me select and then enter the PR number here. Press enter. System is asking for